In this video, we're going to show you how to send a simple message. We'll begin by creating our model in FlexSim. We will need a source, which will produce the items in our system, a queue, which will queue our items before they enter the processors, two processor objects to process the items, and a sync, which will allow our items to leave the system. The final step is to connect our objects. Objects can be connected in one of two ways: by clicking the Connect Objects button on the toolbar, connecting the objects, and then using the Escape key to leave connection mode, or by holding the A key. Using your preferred method, start with the source and click to connect each object downstream towards the sink. We will also need one center port connection, a reference connection that could be done by holding the S key or by choosing Connect Center Ports by clicking the arrow next to the Connect Objects button. Choose your preferred method and click to make a center port connection between the two processors. Now that our model is ready, let's adjust the parameters of the source so we can control its item output. Double-click on the source to bring up its properties window, check the box for arrival at time 0, and change the inter-arrival time to 15. Click OK to save and close the window. While we're at it, let's double-click on the queue and change its maximum content to 20, which limits how many items can stack up in the queue. Now we're ready to add the simple message logic. Double-click on the first processor, click on the Triggers tab, and click the green plus sign to add an on-entry trigger. Select Close and Open Ports from the drop-down list and use the default settings, which close the processor's input port. The on-entry trigger means each time an item enters the processor, the input port is closed so that the processor no longer accepts items for processing. Click OK to save and close. Next, we'd like the input port that we just closed to open back up again once an item leaves the second processor. To do this, we'll need an on-exit trigger, so double-click on the second processor, go to the Triggers tab, and click the green plus sign to add one. This time, select Send Message from the drop-down list and use the default settings again. By default, the message will be sent from Current, which is the current processor, to Center Object open paren current comma 1 close paren, which is the object on the other side of that center port connection that we made earlier, and just so happens to be the first processor. Finally, we need to go back to the properties of our first processor and add one more trigger that accounts for the message we're sending. Add an onMessage trigger, select Conditionally Close and Open Ports from the drop-down list, and change the action to Open Input. This trigger will reopen the processor's input port each time we receive a message. Let's click Reset and run the model. Boxes will be created by the source and will begin to be processed. Notice that the input port of the first processor closes as soon as an item enters, and it doesn't accept anything else for processing until that item finishes at the second processor. We can also send messages without using a center port connection. Stop the model and delete the center port connection between the processors, either by holding the W key or by choosing Disconnect Center Ports by clicking the arrow next to the Disconnect Objects button. Click between the processors to delete the connections, and then double-click on the second processor. Go to the Triggers tab, click the button where the green plus sign used to be next to our on-exit trigger, and click the white arrow to see our Send Message trigger settings. We want to adjust where the message is sending to, so type in object, open paren current, comma 1, close paren. This refers to the object that is connected to our processor's input port, which happens to be the first processor. If you reset and run the model again, the processors will behave exactly as they did when they were linked by a center port connection. Thank you for watching. For more information on FlexSim products, or to view more tips and tricks for successful modeling, please visit www.flexsim.com.